Howdy, 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 everybody. I hope you're all well. I'm well. I'm ready to rock this. We've been talking about doing some, ooh, there we go. That's the music. That's the music. So we have been talking about doing some Monkey Island stream here for a while. And I am fairly pumped about it. So, we're gonna make this puppy happen. I'm pretty pumped about it. I hope you're pumped about it. Super special welcome to all the people that decided to join, hang out with us for a little while. There's one thing that I've done with this game that is different than what the game normally runs at, and that is I have updated the hair. Guybrush has stupid hair, so there's a patch that someone made to fix his hair and make it look more like Monkey Island 2 and 3 and so forth. I also have rum. That's right. Make sure these sounds work. Because we're going to need them. Right? Oh no, soundboard, are you broken? Alright, hold on to your butts. I tested everything before starting. And then I broke it because I started. Come on now. There we go. Boom. Now we're good. We gotta make sure we got all this stuff ready. Alright, man. Let's play some Monkey Island. Let's not dilly-dally. Let's just play the game. Deep in the Caribbean. Stuff happens. On the island of Melee. Melee Island's kind of awesome. That's where I take fools. When I want to show them what's what. So, Ron Gilbert, Dave Grossman, and Tim Schafer worked on this game together. If you remember, when we played through Day of the Tentacle, Dave Grossman and Tim Schafer worked on that one. Yeah, isn't that cool? Aw, press the button again. Dave Grossman and Tim Schafer worked on Day of the Tentacle. So they kind of, got stuff figured out between Monkey Island and Monkey Island 2. This mug is fun. It's also full of rum, and I keep sipping it like it's just milk or something. I'm gonna get to a point when I'm playing this that it's just like, uh-oh. Homeboy's not doing these puzzles so well because his ears are hot. But Ron Gilbert would love to do a Monkey Island 3. So there's been 1, 2, 3, 4. There's been 5 Monkey Islands. 1 and 2, and then Monkey Island 1 and 2 were Ron Gilbert games. Then Monkey Island 3 came out, and that was not. That was just, you know, it's under the LucasArts banner. So, oh, we're about to get started. Let's listen in, shall we?
Hi, my name's Guybrush Threepwood, and I want to be a pirate.
Yikes! Don't sneak up on me like that.
I'm over this way.
Ah, well then, Thriftweed.
Threepwood. Guybrush Threepwood.
I see. So, you want to be a pirate, eh? You look more like a flooring inspector. But if you're serious about pirating, go talk to the pirate leaders.
Aha!
You'll find them in the scum bar.
Gosh, thanks. I'll do that. Bye now.
It's our first clue.
I'm off to seek my fortune.
Good luck.
Where did you say those pirate leaders were?
The scum bar.
Right. Thanks.
The music's overloading the vocals a little bit, so I'm gonna fix that. There's always 3 trials. It's very important. 3 is a magic number in video games. Let's adjust that music just a smidge, because it's a little loud in comparison to the voices. All right, resume the game. We have a verb list, right? Okay, cool. This is part of my struggle last time, was trying to work this stuff.
Re-elect Governor Marley. When there's only one candidate, there's only one choice.
Politics? What? It's really pretty. Like, I don't know what they're doing to make this water look all fun. But they did a really good job repainting this. So that it looks all nice. I think you'd right-click to open. Yeah. Right-click to open. Right-click to close. I got this. I want to be this guy. I want to be having such a good time that I'm swinging from the chandeliers. I think that's
Ahoy
my goal.
Ahoy there, stranger. New in town?
My name's Guybrush Threepwood. Let's see.
Are you a pirate? Can I be on your crew?
Well, I am a pirate. But alas, I'm not a captain.
Arr, matey.
You should go talk to the important-looking pirates.
Why not?
In the next room. They're pretty much in charge around here. They can tell you where to go.
If my dumb head is on the wrong side of the screen. Yeah, I'm totally blocking. Hold on. Blurp, blurp, blurp. That's going to feel weird. It's going to feel really weird. Let's try it anyway. Because I'm looking this way. That's not gonna fly. We'll just suffer through it.
My name's Guybrush Threepwood. I'm new in town.
Guybrush Threepwood?
What kind of name is that?
That's the stupidest name I've ever heard.
Well, what's your name?
Well, what's your name?
My name is Mancomb Seepgood.
I feel like I just flipped the image. But then even the words would be, oh. Dressed, you're a genius. You're a genius. Let's see, rotate. Rotate 100. Oop, that not. That didn't do it. Flip horizontal, I think, is what we're going for. Flip horizontal. Put me over here. There we go. And then the chit chat is over here. This is going to be in the way anyway. It's cool. We got this. You and me. I'm supposed to be solving puzzles. Oops. Not fiddling with this. All right. Oh, this is
nice talking to you.
Nice talking to you.
What's done talking to you?
Have fun on Melee Island.
All right. We're going to talk to him again because
nice to see
I didn't get to
again.
Ask him that last question. Where can I find the governor?
Where can I find the governor?
Governor Marley. Her mansion is on the other side of town. But pirates aren't as welcome around her place as they used to be.
Apparently so. Melee has entirely too many accents. I agree. Yarr. I'm welcome everywhere I go.
Whatever you say, just watch out for those guard dogs.
Yarr. I'll be watching them.
Looks like my grog is going flat. So you'll have to excuse me. Nice talking to you. Have fun on Melee Island.
I love they put the little TM. That's my favorite thing. See, I want to talk to these guys. Can I?
I think they're busy.
Oh, they look busy, but these guys aren't busy? I like this dude in the tiny hat.
Hi.
Ask me about Loom. So Loom was an adventure game LucasArts made prior to this.
So, tell me about Loom.
You mean the latest masterpiece of fantasy storytelling from Lucasfilm's Brian Moriarty? Why, it's an extraordinary adventure with an interface of magic.
We're going to play that one, by the
stunning
way. There's a
plan. High-resolution 3D landscapes, sophisticated score and musical effects, not to mention the detailed animation and special effects, elegant point-and-click control of characters, objects and magic spells.
Excellent pitch.
Beat the rush. Go out and buy Loom today.
Nice hat.
Nice hat.
Hi.
Okay. Nice talk to you.
Hi.
I love that. There was totally just a sales pitch for Loom. Okay, so whatever's on the left is the active verb when I left click. Whatever's on the right is the active verb when I right click. Alright, I got this. Alright, let's talk to the important looking pirates.
What be ye wanting, boy?
I mean to kill you all.
I mean to kill you all.
Get lost, boy. You bother us.
Oh, well, okay. Let's try that again. Boy. I want to be a pirate.
I want to be a pirate.
So what?
Why bother us?
Hey, don't forget we're short on help because of this whole LeChuck thing.
So?
LeChuck thing?
No pirates means no swag, and no swag means no grog, and we're getting dangerously low on grog.
We can't have that.
Do you have any special skills?
I can hold my breath for 10 minutes.
It's a skill, if you ask me. I can only hold my breath for like 20 seconds.
All right, but you don't become a pirate
all the smoking.
Just by asking.
You'll have to go through the three trials.
What three trials are those?
There are three trials every pirate must pass.
You must master the sword
and the art of thievery.
And the quest.
The sword, the thievery, and the quest.
Treasure hunting, you sea urchin.
Right. You must prove yourself in each of these three areas.
Oh, I'll prove myself.
Swordplay, thievery, and treasure hunting.
I'm drinking this too fast.
Then return with proof that you've done it.
I mean, you're supposed to drink rum, though, right?
You must drink grog with us. Grog!
That's what I need. I need a giant mug that says grog on it for when we're playing these games. Tell me more about mastering the sword.
Tell me more about mastering the sword.
First, get here your sword. You must seek out and defeat the sword master.
Should I write this down?
Someone in town can probably direct you. Oh! You want to find somebody to train you first.
Imagine trying to take on the sword master without any training.
All right, tell me the art of
tell
mastering.
Tell me more about mastering the art of thievery.
We want to
I should let him
talk.
A
small item for us.
The idol of many hands in the governor's mansion.
The governor keeps the idol of many hands in a display case in the mansion outside the town.
I'll take it.
You'll have to get past the guard.
That thing's as good as mine.
The tricky part will be getting past the dogs outside. Hey, they're a particularly vicious breed. You might be able to drug them or something.
I'll drug them. Tell me more about treasure hunting.
Tell me more about treasure hunting.
Legend has it that there's a treasure buried here on the island. All you must do is find the legendary lost treasure of Melee Island and bring it back here.
That TM is awesome.
Should I have a map or something?
Well, you can hardly expect to find a treasure without a map.
And don't forget, X marks the spot!
Unless you're a fan of Indiana Jones. All right, let's see. What's in grog anyway?
Grog stuff anyway.
We need to know.
Grog
oh, we can make
is
it.
A secret mixture which contains one or more of the following:
kerosene,
propylene glycol,
artificial sweeteners, sulfuric acid,
rum,
acetone, red dye number 2,
scum,
axle grease, battery acid,
and or pepperoni. As you can probably imagine, it's one of the most caustic, volatile.
It's like a rum and coke with extra poison.
The stuff eats right through these mugs, and the cook is losing a fortune replacing them.
You're a bunch of foul-smelling, grog-swilling pigs.
To be a pirate, you must also be a foul-smelling, grog-swilling pig.
Perfect. All right.
I'll just be running along now.
So, step 2.
Leave us to our grog.
Step 2
come
in adventure gaming
and
is
tell us how you're doing.
Stealing everything that's not nailed down. And I played this recently, and I know that there's a guy that comes out of there.
You can't come back here.
And I can go in there and steal some stuff. So that's what we're going to do. See, did you hear that? Door open. Go in here and we'll steal stuff.
It's some sort of meat or meat-like substance.
Let's pick up meat. And let's pick up pot of stew, maybe?
It's boiling hot.
I want that fish. Pick up fish.
I think that bird will peck my hand off.
All right. Well, that's not going to work. I'm supposed to do something. Let's see. What do I do? Inventory? Aha!
It's some sort of meat or meat-like substance.
What do I do? Let's see. Use. Use hunk of meat with pot of stew. Meat and stew.
Stewed meat. Ow! Got it!
All right. I got some stewed meat now. I don't know if that was important.
I think that bird will peck my hand off.
Well, I throw something at the bird. I want that fish. Ooh, a pot.
Someone cooked a head cheese in this.
I'm going to pick up the pot. Aha! Like I said, steal everything that's not nailed down. I wonder if I can use the
pot. Someone cooked a head cheese in this.
With the pot of stew.
I don't want to put that in.
Alright, fair enough. What's the... You look at the barrel. There's all these little shortcuts.
Foul stuff pirates drink.
Use pot with barrel.
I don't want that much.
Okay, fair enough. How do I get rid of this bird? Use hunk of meat. You can't click the bird, so it's definitely something to do with the fish. Burp, 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 burp.
I don't see anything special about it.
Alright.
I think that bird will peck my hand off.
A bird is just going to eat an infinite fish. Fish will never disappear. Well, we got stewed meat. That's important enough. Let's talk to the dog. Spiffy.
Rough. LeChuck.
Something something Melee Island LeChuck.
Woof LeChuck.
He looks so sinister for being so kind. Anybody speak dog?
Chuck.
He knows something. He knows something he can't tell me about.
Meanwhile, deep beneath Monkey Island, the ghost pirate LeChuck's ship lies anchored in a
LeChuck's
river
theme.
Of lava.
Captain LeChuck, sir.
There's nothing like the hot winds of hell blowing in your face.
No, sir. Nothing like it. sir, I...
It's days like this that make you glad to be dead.
Oh, yes, sir. Glad to be dead.
Who's that voice actor? Because
it
sounds really
glad
familiar.
To be dead, right?
Oh, yes, sir. I feel so lucky that you happened to capture my ship, then murdered me and everyone on board. Yes, yes, sir. Lucky.
Glad to hear it. Now, what was it you disturbed me for?
Yes, sir. Well, you see, we might have a problem on Melee Island.
Problem? What possible problem could there be? I've got those sissy pirates so scared of the sea, they're afraid to take a bath.
Well, there seems to be a new pirate in town. Actually, he's a pirate wannabe. Young.
I am scaring LeChuck with how awesome.
Probably nothing to worry about. Don't know why I bother you with it. I'll have him taken care of myself.
Wait! I'll handle this personally. My plans are too important to be messed up by amateurs.
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm. Let's take a walk. Let's see what we can find today. Hello, citizen.
Excuse me, but do you have a cousin named Sven?
What is that? Some sort of code?
Of course it's a code, you idiot. Never mind. Good night.
Arg.
Excuse me, but...
Talk to him again.
Now it's only you again.
My cousin Sven sends his regards.
My cousin Sven sends his regards.
We're the smartest people ever.
Let's talk business. You want to buy a map to the legendary lost treasure of Melee Island?
Yes.
Only one in existence. Rare. Very rare. Only 100
pieces
of
it. It's a shifty guy.
Eight.
I don't have any money.
No thanks. I don't have enough money.
Well then, buzz off, kid. It's bad for business.
I find myself, since we were playing Diablo last night on stream, putting my fingers across 1, 2, 3, and 4 when there's absolutely no use to even be near the keyboard. So I need 100 pieces of 8.
Hey, don't mess with my rat!
I'm gonna talk to these pirates of low moral fiber. Hey, who are you? You're just a pirate guy just walking around town? What do you think you're doing? Going in and out of doors and stuff.
Hey, nice rat. Rat.
Do you like rats?
Yes, especially in a nice light wine sauce.
Yes, especially in a light wine sauce.
Get away!
Do you guys know anything about the sneaky
looking
man?
Do you guys know the sneaky looking man on the opposite corner?
Wanna buy a map, eh? Our maps are top quality. Not like the birdcage liners you get from that clown across the street.
Now I have choices to make.
Nah, just kidding. These are actually copies of the minutes of the last meeting of the Melee Island PTA. Can't even give them away.
Get these three stooges over here. No, but I'll take one if you give me 2 pieces of 8. Give me money to take your minutes.
No, but I'll take one if you give me 2 pieces of 8.
Okay, that's fair.
Yeah. So are you guys pirates?
Say, are you guys pirates?
No, we're a wandering circus troupe.
But this rat scared away the elephant.
Shut up! Of course we're pirates. You can't buy clothes like these off the rack.
What do you want?
Let's see, what's in the keg? How come you're on the street corner and not on a ship looting, pillaging, sacking, and that sort of thing? Sorry, I verbally abused your rat. What's in the keg?
What's in the keg?
Rum.
Jam.
Jam.
Rum. Rum and jam. It's an old pirate favorite. Everybody knows that.
Rum and jam. I'm really interested in the pirating
I'm really
thing.
Interested in this pirating thing.
What do you want?
Let's see.
Sorry I verbally abused your rat.
They're very intelligent creatures. More intelligent than him.
Though I believe that.
There's a story around these parts that a bunch of rats actually crewed a ship here from fabled Monkey Island.
Monkey Island TM.
No, that's not right. It was actually a group of monkeys.
That's difficult to believe.
That's difficult to believe.
Yes, but it's true. When they arrived, they sold the ship for a pretty penny. Only time I've seen anyone get the better of old Stan in a deal.
I thought it was rats.
I'm really interested in this.
Let's ask him the one more question we have.
What do you want?
So I think we've got
How come you're on this street corner and not on a ship, looting, pillaging, sacking, that sort of thing?
Well, pirating hasn't been panning out so well for us.
There are some unnaturally talented pirates in the area right now.
Operating out of Monkey Island.
So we've been pursuing alternate means of self-support. We're trying to start up a circus.
It was working out well, until the rats scared off the elephant.
So they weren't lying.
Now you've depressed us. Go home.
I said don't pester the rat.
I just hovered.
I'm not gonna warn you again. Leave the rat alone.
What? That's all. When I hover over the rat, he freaks out.
Hey, man. Frank, make him quit it.
I'm gonna touch it. I'm gonna touch it.
Oh, now look what you did.
That's awesome. That scared the pirate away. Or the rat. That's so cool. All right, let's go into this shop. Looks like the voodoo shop. In. Ooh. This is another place where you just pick up everything.
Poor chickens.
Can I pick up a chicken?
I'd better not. They're probably being saved for a pagan ritual, and I wouldn't want to spoil it. No thanks. I'd rather not touch any of this creepy voodoo stuff. Looks comfortable in a spooky sort of way.
Can I use the couch?
No thanks. I can never fall asleep in strange places. No thanks. I'd rather not touch any of this creepy voodoo stuff.
Well.
I think I hear slithering inside. A rubber chicken with a pulley in the middle.
This is probably...
What possible use could that have?
The rubber chicken with a pulley in the middle is easily the best object in any game ever.
Maybe no one will miss just this one thing. Poor little thing. Whatever it was.
Let's see. Can we take those?
No thanks. I'd rather not touch any of this creepy voodoo stuff.
It's the voodoo knickknacks.
Let's see. There's a jar of bat drippings, a box that says assorted scales, a shaker full of monkey flakes, and some cat knuckles. Cat knuckles? How barbaric!
What's a monkey flake anyway? Oh, hey, voodoo lady.
What
I've just been
may
taking
I
your
help
stuff.
You with, son?
My name's Guybrush Threepwood, and I'm a mighty
Wait.
Pirate.
Wait. Don't say anything. I can sense your name is... Guybrush. Guybrush Nosehair. No. Threepwood. Dang. Guybrush Threepwood.
You're good, voodoo
Am
lady.
Am I not right?
Wow, that was amazing. Do you know any other tricks?
Wow, that was amazing. Do you know any other tricks?
I do not deal in tricks. What I know is the truth.
How much for this keen-looking chicken? Might as well pay for it.
I sense the guilt of stealing my chicken grows. Take it. It's yours.
Yes.
Why don't you want it?
It's mine.
Is it jinxed with an ancient voodoo curse?
No. The pulley squeaks.
Fair enough. Can you read palms? Am I going to be rich?
So? My mind-reading skills tell me it is your future. You are interested in. Are you certain this is something you really wish to know?
Nobody should know their future, but yes.
Yes, tell me everything that's going to happen to me.
I am getting a vision.
Whoa, psychedelic.
I see you taking a voyage, a long voyage. I see you captaining a ship.
Yeah.
I see.
What? See what?
I see a giant monkey.
Yikes.
I see you inside the giant monkey.
Gross.
Things are getting weirder.
Wait. It's all becoming clear. Your journey will have many parts. You will see things better left unseen. You will hear things better left unheard. You will learn things better left unlearned.
What kind of things? I hate surprises.
No. The time is not right to know. When you know your purpose, come see me. I will let you know then.
And down goes voodoo thing.
Yikes!
Where'd you go? But I wanna look over here more. I can't. No, never mind.
Guess I'll just be going now.
I'm gonna have to find out more so that I can learn more, because that makes sense. Knowledge is power. Alright, let's see. Here we go. Can't go in that door. But we can go in the next door. I think this is the... If I remember right, this is the shop. Nope, definitely not the shop. But a nice shortcut. One of these is the shop. Is this the shop? Nope. How about over here? Oh no, it's through the archway. Just keep going and talking to people. This is the information gathering part of the game. Ooh. Whispering in the alley. I'll go see what it is.
Hello? Anybody in here? Hello?
You know, bad things could happen to a person in a dark, deserted alley like this one.
Could they?
And at this time of night, nobody would be around to see it.
Oh, really? That's interesting. Yeah, and bad things happen to people who sneak upon other people
from
behind.
Yeah, and bad things happen to people who sneak up on other people from behind.
Sneak upon. You guys saw that it was missing a space,
so,
too, right?
Because you're going to give me a little attitude, huh? I'd better get your name.
This guy sounds like the same guy who's voiced by LeChuck. Or, same guy. Because people are voiced fail. I'm Guybrush Threepwood, and
I'm Guybrush Threepwood, and I'm a mighty pirate.
Listen, Peepwood.
Threepwood. Guybrush Threepwood.
Well, whatever your name is, listen. I'm the sheriff around here. Sheriff Fester Shinetop. Take it from me. This is a bad time to be visiting Melee Island. A very bad time. My advice to you is to find somewhere else to take your vacation. Somewhere safer.
Oh,
boy,
come on.
I feel much better knowing there's an officer of the law around.
So now I'm in this back alley. Is there anything I can steal back here? What does this show?
Oh, a circus! I love a circus!
Can I take the poster?
I can't pick that up.
Nope. I don't think there's anything else back here. But, as we learned from Full Throttle, you need that camera to pan. It's important. Alright, now let's go in this building right here.
Ahoy there, fancy pants.
Hello.
What do you want?
I'm looking for the Swordmaster of Melee Island.
I'm looking for the Swordmaster of Melee Island.
The Swordmaster of Melee Island?
It's TM at the end of Melee Island.
I don't
awesome.
Know.
Melee
See,
Island
nobody
trademark.
Knows the whereabouts of her secret hideout. Nobody except me. I'd have to go and ask her if it's okay to show you the way. I guess I could hike all the way over there. Once. Be right back. And don't touch anything!
I'm gonna take all your stuff. All your stuff. Got me a sword. I want the shovel, too. Take the shovel. And take everything you've got. I want to use the shovel on this safe.
I don't think that will open it.
And pull it. Hey, I pulled it.
Davy Jones Lockers. The last word in theft, fire, and grog-resistant storage devices.
And I pulled again. Pulled again. Pulled again. What'd I do?
It's locked.
That's curious.
It's locked. It's locked. It's locked.
Something happens. I don't know what yet. Let's see, what does the sign say?
Ring bell for service.
It never fails. I step away from the counter for 2 seconds, and some idiot's already ringing that stupid bell.
I'm not going to be able to steal
the
all this stuff.
Master,
there's no way.
Says you can jump in the lake, by the way. What do you want?
I want to buy this stuff that I don't have any money for. Let's see.
I'm looking
you
for
go,
the Swordmaster of Melee Island.
That's kind of what I thought, Sruslin.
I
think she's going,
by
the way.
She doesn't want to see you.
Maybe Sruslin, if you asked her
S.
again.
S. Russell Inn?
I guess I could hike all the way over there.
I'm going to try to follow
again.
This guy.
Be right back.
I figure it's resetting, but I don't know what it's doing,
and don't
you know?
Touch anything!
Not yet, anyway. I'm sure I'll get a clue at some point. Let's see if I can follow him. I don't know if it'll let me. Nope.
Looking
I've got all
for
that
a
crap
sword,
in my,
master, are ya?
My pockets.
Looking for a little thigh-finger discount, it looks like to me. See if I ever trust you again, devious little shoplifting weasel boy! Maybe you'd like to pay for those.
I just want the stuff. I don't want to pay for the stuff.
About this sword.
Yeah, what about it?
I want it.
I want it.
That's 100 pieces of 8. Take it or leave it.
I don't have 100 pieces of 8.
I don't have enough money.
Figures.
Hey.
How else do you want to waste my time?
I try real hard. I'm going to give myself some points.
About this shovel.
Thanks, Wrestling.
Yeah, what about it?
S. Russell Inn. I might just call you Sruslin until, because it's just easy. Or I could just call you Russell.
I want it.
That would also be easy enough, right?
Ooh, another would-be treasure hunter, eh? That'll cost you 75 pieces of 8.
I don't have that either, man.
75 pieces of 8?
I'm just going to have to leave
I
the stuff behind.
I don't have that much.
Then you better go put it back.
My big dumb head is in the way of this entire scene. I apologize for that. I'm having trouble finding a good place for my head to be where it's not messing things up. So my head's just going to have to be in the
is
middle of this conversation.
Is there something here that
now.
Maybe you can afford?
No, I want to follow you.
I'm looking for the Swordmaster of Melee Island.
Yeah, like I'm going to fall for that one again.
You are, come on.
Oh, please. I won't steal anything this time, I promise.
Go. Take me to the Swordmaster.
I guess I could hike all the way over there again. Be right back.
So I'm going to follow him this time.
I've got my eyes on you, weasel boy. Don't try anything.
I should be able to follow him since I'm not trying to steal everything this time. All right, yeah, let's get on this. In hot pursuit. Dude, your nickname's fine. Don't worry about it. You're great. I'm just happy to have you here. Thanks for joining in. This is the first episode of our full Monkey Island franchise playthrough. We're going to be doing all these games. I've played all of them, but it's been years. I honestly remember very few of the puzzles from this. I think the last time I played this, it was like 99 or 2000. Like, for years. Some puzzles stick in your head, but not all of them. See if we can catch up to him. There goes the storekeeper. So he came to this fork. Alright, follow him through here. Follow him through here. Should have taken those flowers. Yeah, dude, I've played Escape from Monkey Island. I actually was planning on potentially skipping it. But I'm trying to honor the idea of the franchise playthrough. Because I, like you, I didn't really dig number 4. I appreciated some of the ways it looped back to with the Herman Tooth Rat thing. Spoilers. But all in all, the game was not good. In Monkey Combat, I'd kind of rather punch myself in the face than do Monkey Combat again. This is easily the dumbest thing of any. What am I doing? Why am I breaking the bridge again? That was stupid. But Tales of Monkey Island, the Telltale series that they did, was actually really fun. So I might play through Escape from Monkey Island just to call it a complete franchise playthrough. I feel like that's something I should do. So we might just suffer through it.
Stay back here and eavesdrop.
Right?
Hello again,
Monkey
Carla.
Combat was awful.
I thought I told you to get lost.
Actually, I'm here on business.
I almost put this the game down and never finished it because of that.
Face it, you crusty old lech. You'd make any excuse just to come out here and bother me.
Yeah, I guess so.
Tails was rad.
Cut it out. I'm sick of it. Take a hike and don't come out here again. Someone might follow you, and then I'd become another Melee Island tourist attraction.
Hey, it's your loss, baby.
Yeah, right. Now scram.
I feel like they were really ahead of their time that they had a female swordmaster. Like, they could have easily made that a male role, but, I mean, you're talking about, when was this? The late 80s? 89? Something like that? 89, 90? And they had a female main character protagonist? Like, not saying it was revolutionary or anything, but it definitely was against the grain, I think. Ryan Gilbert's pretty good about that. He made mention of Backyard Baseball, a game they made with Humongous Entertainment, actually having almost every archetype of little kid represented, whether it was women, nerds, kids of all colors, and this was years ago, and people were praising FIFA for putting women on the first, women on the cover of FIFA for the first time ever, like, just recently. And he's like, yeah, done that. Yeah, I'm doing the whole deal. If you're MST, if I'm Mystery Science Theater 3000ing EMI, I could be. There's some really good nuggets of awesome in Escape from Monkey Island. Like, Marco Polo cracked me up. But all in all, it's subpar. But I feel like if I'm going to play a franchise playthrough, I kind of have to do it. So it's on the list, and I have the game actually on disc. The only thing is, if I can't get it to run, I'm sure I will find a way. But, you know, running on Windows 10, it was hard enough just getting some of the other games running. But I think I can do... Curse of Monkey Island was the last Scum game, so I think it'll run with Scum VM, but we'll find out.
How dare you approach the Swordmaster without permission, which I surely didn't give you.
No, I followed the guy. My name is Gabbers... My name is Gabbers Threepwood. I've come to kill you.
Why not?
My name is Guybrush Threepwood. I've come to kill you.
Nothing like being honest. But as you have no sword,
I'm not gonna kill him.
I doubt you're really serious.
Aw, don't go away. Like, I got questions. Come back. Come back. I think I've ruined it. Good thing about the way they design these games is there's no deal breakers, man. Alright, we might just have to come back later. She really has no reason to talk to me. Just because I followed a shopkeeper doesn't mean that I win all of a sudden. Doesn't look like there's anything to click either. Good old pixel hunting. As much as I felt like it was cheating with Day of the Tentacle to have that little button, you could hit shift and it would show you all the interactable items. I kind of liked it, but I kind of felt like it was cheating all at the same time. It bothered me. Let's go to the clearing. Let's just go around and see what we can get to. Oh, I remember these guys. These dudes are awesome.
I get in the cannon, but the gunpowder makes me
Oh,
sneeze.
Dude, thanks. No, I really appreciate that. That's good to know. Thank you for
I
the tip.
I hurt my hand taming the lions last week. I hardly think that little scratch compares to my chronic allergy.
I love mixing mojo, by the way.
You get in the cannon. You don't have any allergies, you faker. You get in the cannon.
I love these guys
no,
so much.
No, you get in the cannon. No, you get in the cannon. Slacker. Loser. Ruffian. Fop. Weasel. Weevil. Miscreant. Tony.
I just kind of want to let them yell at each other for a minute.
Well. Scuffler. Mullet head, millet head, pencil head, half head, cheese head, hobby, what? Just to get in the cannon. No, you get in the cannon.
I think we're looping now.
No, you get in the cannon.
All right, let's see.
Ah, your mama wears combat slippers.
A once in a lifetime chance.
Your mama wears combat slippers.
Feed.
a death-defying feat?
Well, not so death-defying, really.
Dangerous a feat?
No, not dangerous at all.
An easy feat.
But exciting.
With the amazing.
Adventurous. Acrobatic.
And exceedingly well-known.
Fabulous. Flying.
Ferruccini Brothers.
That's us.
My brother Alfredo.
And my brother Bill.
Sound good?
Good.
It's very simple, really.
See that cannon over there? All you have to do
is get in the cannon
and we'll shoot you out of it.
Across the room.
Quite safe, actually.
So, what do you say?
I say let's do it. I say how much will you pay me? Better question.
How much will you pay me?
How about 478 pieces of eight?
It's a very specific number.
Okay, sounds good.
Have you got a helmet?
Yes, of course I have.
Of course I have a helmet. What sort of idiot do you take me for?
Because I picked up that pot in the kitchen.
Well,
steal it if it's not nailed down.
We want to be sure
that it's a safe.
Adventure Gaming 101.
Won't you hurt?
No, sorry.
All right, I'm ready to do this. Got your stupid thing. What? No, that's not what I meant to do. Use pot with cannon? How do I do the cannon? Oh, here we go. Let's see. Give pot to Fettuccine Brothers.
Ah, that will work as a helmet.
Now we can do the trick.
Step right over here, son.
Yes. Steal it. If it's not nailed down, try to pick it up.
And the
if it's nailed down, talk to somebody and see if they'll let you pick it up.
The rest.
Echo!
Echo!
It works!
Yay!
Oh, I'm so relieved.
I love Mixing Mojo, Russell.
Are you okay?
That's a great website. I used to be a huge fan of thescumbar.com, which was a Monkey Island fan site. I went there like every day for years. It was before EMI launched. And people were just like, is there ever going to be another game? See, I'm Bobbin.
I'm Bobbin. Are you my mother?
He's all right.
Hooray! We are spared an embarrassing and a financially debilitating lawsuit.
Here is your money, sir.
Just the recompense for aiding us.
Yes, 478 pieces of eight.
The basic theory is fine.
We just need to change the aim a bit.
I'll try it next.
No, I'll do it next.
No, me.
No, me.
Slacker.
Loser.
Ruffian.
Fop.
So, one of the lead dudes, he's either a lead dude or the owner of Mixin' Mojo, actually works at Double Fine now. Towards the end of Broken Age, when they were making that game, they hired him on. Which is really cool. You can be a fan of something for long enough that they're just like, hey, by the way, we should we'll just hire that guy. Because he's kind of awesome. Alright, now that we got our 478 pieces of eight, let's just continue. Yes, dude, the scum bar was good times. The good old days. Start using fop as an insult. Good deal, Dressed.
None shall pass.
I shall pass. What do I talk
to troll? None shall pass. Stop. You must pay a toll.
I got your money. Let's see. How much is the
How
toll?
How much is the toll?
Well, what have you got?
I'm not telling you. Let's see. Some semi-rancid meat. Rubber chicken with a pulley in the middle. 30 pieces of eight.
30 pieces of eight?
Maybe.
I want something that'll attract attention, but have no real importance.
Monkey leash with three collars. That sounds good.
A monkey leash with three collars?
I know I need the chicken with a pulley in the middle.
You have three chances to give me what I want. Then I eat ya.
That's gross. I don't want to be eaten. I don't think I have anything.
None shall pass.
That doesn't seem to work.
None shall pass.
Don't eat
That's
me.
That's pretty useless, but it's not what I want.
I got close. All right.
None shall pass.
Okay, we get it. We get it, troll man. Ah, bloodthirsty pirate. So I don't want a sword fight yet. We know that for sure. Let's go to the island. Because I think that's where, Gabe, I don't know. I don't know if it was Gabez. What was the dude's name? He was, either British or a New Zealand dude. New Zealand? I can't remember, man. I wish I could. I can't remember his name. Was it Chris? Was his name Chris? That sounds familiar, but I'm probably totally wrong. I love what Telltale's doing, man. I wish I could tell you. All I remember is that I was watching the documentary for Broken Age, which is the best documentary of making anything ever. And towards the last episode, he was talking about how he used to work for Mixed Mojo, but I can't remember. Chris, yeah, I think it was Chris. I think it was Chris. If you're a fan of video games at all, and you ever wanted to see how one was made, I can tell you no better information than to go on YouTube and look for Double Fine Adventure, which is on their channel, and watch that entire series. It was absolutely amazing.
All right, Meat Hook.
Hey, I don't like visitors. Who are you?
I'm Bobbin Threadbare. Are you my mother? I'm a pirate cannonball head. Haha.
I'm a pirate cannonball head. Who are you?
My name's Meat Hook, and I think you've got a little attitude problem.
Mm-hmm. I think you've got a little hair problem.
I think you've got a little hair problem.
I come into somebody's house
Jeez,
and just insulting them.
You just don't know when to quit, do you?
Obviously, neither did your barber.
Oh,
nice. That's good. You can watch it in 1080p. I've actually asked for the documentary for Christmas, the Blu-ray package set, because I did watch the whole thing on YouTube, but I'm pumped about the extra commentary, like everything about it that they've added, making it prettier, the whole deal. So I'm excited, but you'll love it, Russell. I promise.
Come to invade my it's the coolest thing home ever. And insult me again, eh?
Watching Tim Schafer work on something is just incredible. Excuse me, but the sign said there were restrooms in here.
Sorry,
but that sign's a little out of date. I used to have a thriving tourist business here. I had animal wax, tattoo demonstrations, souvenirs. But there was a little accident with one of the trained animals. One of our guests was hurt very badly.
How unfortunate.
So I was shut down, put out of business. And since then, I've lived here all alone. And the only company I have is the same beast that mauled that unlucky tourist. The same beast that made me a hermit. A monster that, just by coincidence, is identical to one what attacked me when I was just a child and left me with these hooks instead of hands. A deformed man. Jeez, now I'm all depressed. Thanks a lot. Can't you just leave me alone now?
I've clearly hurt this guy's feelings.
I'm Bobbin Threadbare. Are you my mother?
No. Your mother was a duck. Now beat it.
What was your name
again? Cannonball Head?
Look, I told you not to call me that. My name's Meat Hook. And you still have a little attitude problem.
And you've still
and
got,
you've
a,
still
little
got
hair
a little
problem.
Hair problem.
Why not antagonize him a little bit more?
Jeez, you just don't know when to quit, do you?
Sorry, I was just trying to be funny.
You want to say something funny? Ha ha, watch this. Say hello, Roger.
Hello, Roger.
Pretty good, eh?
He just made his pecs talk.
I got a whole routine, but I don't have the time to do it all right now. Maybe if we're ever on a long ocean voyage together. But until then, I'm a very busy man, so.
Could you just show me that Neato tattoo thing
again?
Well, okay, but just one more time. Ha ha, watch this. Say hello, Roger.
Hello, Roger.
That's awesome.
Whoops, I just realized that this is the wrong house.
Oh, okay. Have a nice time on Melee Island.
I have to come back.
Say goodbye, Roger.
Goodbye, Roger.
I don't know when I'm going to need him, but I'm going to need him sometime soon. That's awesome. Yeah, really, Russell, I've watched that documentary twice all the way through, and I want to watch it again. I'm a big fan of anything about making stuff, though,
wow.
So...
it works both ways. That's some chicken.
Like, I'm the kind of guy that watches all the extra content on Blu-rays you buy just because I need to see all the behind-the-scenes stuff, because it, to me, it's as interesting as the actual movie itself. Oh, I'm going to have to argue with this guy. Here we go. Oh, no. Good. I don't think you have to insult any of the pirates till later. I might be wrong. Well, I've got pieces of eight now, so let's go talk to those dudes in the alleyway. Let's talk to this guy, too. Do you ever wonder if we're all just characters in a novel?
Do you ever wonder if we're all just characters in a novel?
Yikes! Oh, you almost scared me to death.
I
thought
you
were a... oh, never mind. What did you say your name was again?
Call me Squinky. Let's see. Let's just be straight with it.
I'm Guybrush Threepwood. I came to Melee Island because I want to be a pirate.
Well, you picked the right place for it. Though perhaps the wrong time. Not to mention the wrong name. You have the silliest name I've heard.
Dude, that would be fun
time.
Dress. Doing a Lord of the Rings marathon with commentary. I'll take it. That'd be awesome.
What the heck is wrong with Guybrush?
I would love to sit on the couch and just listen and be like, oh my gosh, listen to all the awesome things they did.
I think if you want to sell shoes, you want to be a pirate, boy, take my advice. Change your name. Try something like Dreadbeard or Six-Fingered Pete.
I wonder if that's a reference to the Six-Fingered Man from Princess Bride. Someone should find out.
Who are you?
I'm the lookout of Melee Island. I watch the ocean for approaching storms and ships and report them directly to the governor. She doesn't like unexpected visitors, especially not now.
How'd you get to be on the lookout when you're obviously blind as a bat?
How did you get to be the lookout when you're obviously blind as a bat?
Watch your tongue. I was handpicked by Sheriff Shinetop.
Ah.
Why is the governor worried about unexpected visitors?
Actually, it's the expected visitors we're worried about.
All the rum is gone.
One pirate captain in particular. A dead one, but that doesn't make him any less dangerous.
I'm over here.
Huh?
I'll just be off to seek my fortune now.
Good luck!
I bet the commentary for Lord of the Rings was pretty awesome. Those people hung out together for a very long time to make that movie. That movie. Those three movies. Though I have to say, I haven't seen the third Hobbit yet, and I'm not in a hurry. For reasons, like, everybody pretty much agrees with. Oops. Clicked outside the window. My bad. Okay, cool. That is a Princess Bride reference. How long ago did you play this, Russell? Like, what was your most recent playthrough?
Excuse me, but do... oh, it's only you.
Hobbit was a huge disappointment.
Come back for the map to the legendary lost treasure of Melee Island, huh?
Yes, I want to buy your map.
I hope you brought enough money this time.
I did. I got a job getting shot out of cannons. I'll take it.
I'll take it. It'll make a swell gift.
The Hobbit could have easily been,
made a wise decision.
At best, two movies. Lost. I mean, at best, two movies. Like, two-hour normal-length movies. Not three-hour epic movies where they added so much it was unrecognizable. All right, now we got a map. Let's go buy these two things that I want to buy. The sword and the shovel. pick up the shovel. I just read a book, listened to an audiobook of Carrie Elwes, As You Wish. Very, very good book about the making of The Princess Bride, like stories from behind the scenes and how the cast got along and little fun nuggets of information. Really good book. If you're a Princess Bride fan, I highly recommend it. And the audiobook is read by Carrie Elwes, which is even more fun. And read by Carrie Elwes with Billy Crystal, Robin Wright, Rob Reiner, like a bunch of the people that worked on it tell their own stories as part of the audiobook. It was really good. Right, dude dressed. He was a master storyteller, and they should have just told the story. I agree 100%. I actually have read a lot of The Hobbit to Sam, even though he's younger and not old enough to understand anything. I just sat and read to him when he was just first born, because it was just a time at night where Stephanie was holding him and feeding him, and I could just, you know, talk to him. Which is, you do weird things when you become a dad. But picked out The Hobbit to read him. That book is incredibly conducive to reading to someone, because it's written as if Tolkien is just telling the story to you. So it's really fun to read it out loud to somebody else. It works real well for that. So if you ever want to read to somebody, it's a great book to pick.
It'd be you again.
Okay, cool, Russell. Randomly just two weeks ago.
The Swordmaster says you can jump in the lake, by the way. What do you want?
I want to buy this
stuff. About this sword.
Yeah, what about it?
Okay, that's awesome. They were stories that he actually told to his kids. Cool.
I want it.
Great.
Yeah, Russell, it was a good audiobook.
Best 100 pieces
really, really
of eight you ever spent. What else do you want?
Carrie Elwes is a natural performer, so him reading an audiobook is perfect.
About this shovel.
Yeah, what about it?
I want to buy it.
I want it.
Great. Oh, it'll pay for itself, believe me.
If I can find the treasure.
Hey, you'll dig up 75 pieces of eight in no time. But hey, save some treasure for the rest of us, would you? What else do you want?
I don't think I need anything else.
I think I'd just like to browse.
I'm good. I think those are the two main things I need from in here.
Wake me up if you need anything.
Burr, 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 burr. Thanks, sword dude. Now we can go down the street a little bit more. So we haven't explored this whole area at all. Into the church. Where there's awesome music playing and nothing to do yet. I believe that will change. But we'll see. Did you play the old school one, Russell? Or did you play the special edition like I'm doing now? So I used to have the old one, but I kind of like... I don't like the interface with the special edition that much. I kind of prefer the verbs at the bottom, like the old way that it was done, than this little weirdo right-click, left-click interface, but it's all right. Hey, that rat. I want to talk to you.
You gotta get me out of here! I'm a victim of society!
You got to get me out of here.
Not to mention halitosis.
Ugh. Hey. It's hard to keep my breath minty fresh when there's nothing to eat in here but rats.
So, can I talk to you, or
talk
is it still gross?
Death breath? No thanks.
Still gross.
It's locked.
Let's see, let's poke around. It's locked.
It's locked. It's locked.
Okay. There's a rat in there. What do I have in my pockets? I got a sword now, I got some money. Got a map.
I think I've been had. This is no map. It looks like dancing lessons.
Oh, I'm gonna need this. Back, two, three, four, left, back, left, right, back, right, left, back, cha, cha, cha. I think this matters, but I don't remember when. Oh, yeah. These games are great. I think. So, the first game I ever actually played on a computer was Putt-Putt Goes to the Moon. And I had no idea until many, many, many years later that that was actually a Ron Gilbert game. Because it was produced by Humongous Games, which is the company he formed after leaving LucasArts. So, I've been an adventure fan of Ron Gilbert's games for years and years and years. Because I was 8 when we had an old Packard Bell. I wasn't enough of a computer nerd at the time to tell you what that machine was running, but it was old. It did have a CD-ROM drive in it, though, which was newish at the time. This is 93. Can I feed the piranha poodles this stewed meat? They might just eat it. I don't think I can drug them. Yeah, that didn't work. I'm gonna have to get more stewed meat. See, everybody knows what kind of computer they had. I totally didn't know anything about my machine. I know it had 8 megabytes of RAM. Well, it had 4. It had 4 megabytes of RAM. And we upgraded it to 8 later on, because people... We got all our information from friends. We were like, hey, how do you make a computer faster? More RAM! We're like, okay, let's put more RAM in it. I didn't know a darn thing. You have the processor in your wallet? Is it just for fun? I carry a paperclip in my wallet. All the time. Paperclip is like a multi-tool for nerds. So much can be done with a paperclip. Need to reset your router? Paperclip. Need to get a CD out of a drive that's busted? Paperclip. So many choices.
Hey! You can't come back here!
I know. I screwed up. I guess if you ever were in the woods and somebody, like, comes out of the woods and goes, hey man, I'm gonna hang you up by your toes unless you give me a 386 processor. I'm going.
Hey, don't go into the kitchen!
I'm going. I'm going, I'm taking this. I'm gonna stew it in the meat. I'm gonna put it in the pot of stew again. I'm gonna pick it up out of the pot of stew.
Ow! Got it!
And I'm gonna... Can I fill it with grog, I wonder? Use stewed meat with barrel.
That doesn't seem to work.
Nah, of course not. What do I have? A sword. What do I use for drugs? I knew I made them pass out at one point.
But that doesn't seem to work.
Use sword.
That doesn't seem to work.
It won't let me use it with something. Use shovel with fish.
That doesn't seem to work.
Of course not. I didn't feel like that would work. So I've got a map. What is this?
There sure are a lot of spelling errors.
How do I get rid of that bird?
I think that bird will peck
my hand
off. All
right, well, we got our stewed meat again. We just got to figure out how to poison it. Don't think I can do anything in here. Okay, let's think. Where would we find? I keep clicking the wrong button. I'm so close on the fish. So close on the fish. Oh, now you told me, and now I'm all obsessed about it. By the way, I am good with tips, but mostly in a sense that we play through it together, if that makes any sense. And that, like, what you said is totally fine. The only thing I'm careful with is I hate walkthrough tips. That's like the only major deal that I worry about, that I prefer not to have, is like somebody who's just like, yeah, just do this, and they know it. I know it's kind of hard for me to distinguish between, like, you knowing it and me just jibber jabbering about it. Let's see if we can figure this out, because I think this map has something to do with the woods. Back left right, back left right, back left right. Let's see. Back, I think. I don't think... Yeah, because that's how you leave. Okay. Wait. No, I don't want to go to the Swordmaster's. No, crap. That's what I wanted to do. I want to go to the fork. Because I'm pretty sure... Ooh, plants. Can I pick up a plant?
My, what an unusually bright yellow they are.
Can I pick them up? Pick up plants? Aha! Got some yellow plants. Get back. Let's just go left. Alright, man. These plants.
I can't pick that up.
Back, left, right. That's what we just did, so. Back, left, right. Left, right, back. Back, left, right. Left. Right. I don't know if I'm doing it right or not. Back. What's this stump? Can I use the stump?
That doesn't seem to work. Just a regular old stump.
I bet it is. Alright, now let's set our inventory again. Right, left, back. Okay, right, left, back.
What a lovely plant. I can't pick that up.
Right. Left. Back. I don't know if this is going to do anything. Oh, a clearing. Maybe? Aha! We have found something. We are smart people.
Here lies treasure of such unimaginable wealth. Well, you'll just have to dig it up to believe it.
Yes!
Paid for by the Melee Island Chamber of Commerce. The legendary lost treasure of Melee Island. This carefully reproduced piece of Melee Island history has delighted thousands of would-be pirates and their families for generations. Remember, there are other pirates on this island. So go easy on the treasure. Leave some for the next person.
I feel like I've just been geocaching. Use the sword on...
this shouldn't take too long.
Or use the shovel. Shovel, sword.
Hours pass.
Love the voice actor right there.
Hey, I think I hit something.
It's a water main.
Oh boy. It's a t-shirt. Not my size, but a nice one nonetheless.
I wonder if
that
will attract.
I guess I should put all this dirt back now.
More hours pass.
Wow, it looks perfect. That looks like something that will attract attention, but be of very little importance. I knew those dancing steps were actually something we could use. Let's go give it to the dude. Actually, let's fight this bloodthirsty pirate. Come here, bloodthirsty pirate. I want to fight you. Didn't work. That was awesome! I can't believe you did that! We solved that puzzle! Let's see if we can give this shirt to this dude, because I feel like this...
That's pretty useless, but it's not what I want.
So close.
None shall pass!
It's a striking yellow color.
None shall pass! None shall pass!
I put the yellow petal
shall pass.
In the stewed meat. I'm wondering if that's gonna get the dogs. Oh, but if we screw that up, what's down here? Nothing. That might get the dogs. If that gets the dogs, we'll be in good shape. Lookout point, village. Let's just go straight to the village. At least I let you teleport past all that stuff. You don't have to walk through the lookout every time. I wish it would get me to the other side of the city, though. Who would need a t-shirt? Oh, I need the t-shirt because I found the lost treasure. That's what it is. That's for the three trials. Alright. That makes sense. Good to go on that. So now let's keep wandering. I wonder if that flower will put these dogs to sleep. Let's try it. I mean, the yellow petal could be like a thing. They might just eat it. I don't know. Yes!
Important notice. These dogs are not dead. They are only sleeping. No animals were harmed during the production of this game.
Yeah, we did it. We did it. Let's go in and steal some stuff. Just walk right into her office or her house. Not a problem at all. All right. Cooked piranha? Where do you even get piranha? Like, where does that come from? Where do you get piranha from? Wonder. Let's look at the books.
No time for reading now.
Okie dokie. Oh, in Peru. Yeah, that'll do it.
This door appears to be locked.
I gotta be able to get in there. I don't see a display case anywhere.
I don't recognize the man, but that looks like the dog in the bar.
Aha! Maybe we open this door. Yes! Uh-oh.
This looks like a job for Fester Shinetop.
I vaguely remember this happening. Hypnotized quarrelsome rhinoceros. Look at that stuff on the bottom left. Oh, you can't see it. Dang it.
No.
Chat's in the way.
Not the red button.
Push red button. Look at Tremendous Yak.
It's a big, ugly, hairy yak wearing some wax lips.
It's a pretty interesting room. Push Tremendous Dangerously Looking Yak.
I can't move it.
Pull Tremendous Dangerous Looking Yak.
I can't move it.
Pick up Staple Remover. Use Staple Remover on Tremendous Dangerous Looking Yak. Pick up Manual of Style.
I'll need this. I must be nuts.
Pick up Wax Lips. Walk to...
Back! Gophers!
Pick up Gopher Repellent. Use Gopher Repellent with Gopher. Use Gopher Repellent with another Gopher. Use Gopher Repellent with Gopher Horde. Use Gopher Repellent with Funny Little Man. Look at Fabulous Idol.
It's beautiful.
Open. Lock.
I can't open it.
Okay. Fair enough.
Uh-oh.
Pick up Heavy Chair. Use Heavy Chair with Sheriff.
That should hold him for a while. If only I had a file, I could get the idol.
Oh, geez. I need a file now? I don't have a file, but I have... Oh, look at all this stuff. I got Staple Removers and Wax Lips and Gopher Repellent. I need a file. That was kind of awesome. Like, I know that was kind of a cheap thing to do with back in the day when they didn't have enough resources to make things animate super well. But it was pretty awesome nonetheless. It was a really clever workaround for not being able to show an actual fight scene. I don't want to touch those guys. I need a file. Oh, I bet the prisoners might have a file. Do I have anything I can give? Let's go into the prison. I don't think I have anything to give the prisoner yet. Can I use this on the rat?
Talk to Death Breath? No thanks.
At some point I get mints. I don't remember when to get the mints. Or where to get the mints. Yeah, dude, it was funnier because they didn't show anything. Using the verbs at the bottom to tell you what was going on is probably the best part. Do you guys have anything new to say?
I'll just be running along now.
What about... I need to go back in here. I feel like I missed something in Voodoo Lady's place. Bones. Let's see if she'll talk to me about stuff yet.
Hey, I'm back and I'm ready to know more about the future. Guess no one's here.
Ah, bummer. Chickens, couch, statue, baskets.
Gee, I wonder what's in these baskets. Actually, I'm not that curious to find out what's inside. Probably poisonous snakes.
Probably. Let's talk to this guy. Maybe he sells breath mints. Where did I get those breath mints?
Excuse me, but it's only you again. I told you there was only one in existence.
And I used it.
Now get lost.
Alright, fine. Let's go back to the scum bar. Let's figure out that fish. Russell says I'm close to the fish. Oof. All right.
Well, if it isn't the boy who wants to be a pirate.
I found the treasure.
Any fair on your quests.
I found your legendary lost treasure.
Well, I discovered the lost treasure, eh? You're a clever boy. You may keep the chic t-shirt. We have plenty.
I'll just be running along now.
All right.
Leave us to our grog.
Come back later and tell us how you're doing.
Cozy.
All right. Let's get Cook Guy to come out of his hole. If I can go in there. Come out. Hey, Cook Guy.
Hey! You can't come back here!
Watch me. Oops. Keep clicking outside the window. Oops. Did it again. There he goes. Alright, Cookie. Oh, dude, Scum Buddy. I love it. I'm gonna beat you.
Hey! Don't go into the kitchen!
Scum Buddy is...
Hey! Don't go into the kitchen!
Hey, you go away so I can go into your kitchen. Keep walking. Thank you. Oh, more... Can I take more
it's
meat?
Some sort of meat or meat-like substance.
I've already put the dogs to sleep, but... We'll do this again because, I mean, why not?
Ow! Got it!
All right, bird. You and me about to have some words.
That doesn't seem to work.
Use shovel with fish.
That doesn't seem to work.
Use chicken.
That doesn't seem to work.
Use gopher repellent.
That doesn't seem to work.
Hey, repel a gopher. What can I use?
That doesn't seem to work.
Won't let me use anything with the birds. That's
they're
not working.
Yak-sized and covered with slobber. I'm certainly not going to chew on them.
No, like, I don't feel like I did anything special last time. Like, when I played this before, I don't remember having to work that hard to pick up the fish.
I think that bird will peck my hand off.
Ah. Use shovel. Fish.
That doesn't seem to work. I don't see anything special about it. That doesn't seem to work.
See, I can't use the sword. That's the thing that's throwing me off.
I think it's a herring.
A red herring.
I think that bird will peck my hand
a
off.
A red herring. Really now? I can't think of anything I need the fish for. And I have a sword now. So let's... We'll worry about the fish later. The fish will be there. Let's keep clicking outside the window. Why don't we do that? Clicking outside the window is a great strategy for how to get through this game. And you're like, Steven, why aren't you running in full screen? I kept having fits with the full screen. Let's go see if we can talk to the Swordmaster. We have a sword now, which is part of the challenge there, I think. I really want to get through the three trials. Scumbuddy, do you do adventure game streams also? Is that a thing that you're into? Because I've done a few adventure games so far. I did Day of the Tentacle. I think I didn't do a full run of Day of the Tentacle. I only streamed like the last little bit of me playing it. But we did do a full stream of Full Throttle, which was super fun. We're going to do that again when the remastered version comes out.
How dare you approach the Swordmaster with...
I have a sword.
Oh, it's you again.
Let's see. I don't want to come to kill you this time.
I beg your pardon. I must talk to you.
I doubt that.
No, I must.
Everyone who comes here is prepared to fight. Let's be honest. You're here to prove yourself to the pirate leaders in hopes
yes.
of one day being as immoral as they are.
Yep. Nailed it right on the head. Gee, you're smart.
What was your final grade in Captain Smirk's sword fighting class?
Grade? Class?
You mean you came here to take on the Swordmaster of Melee Island, possibly the greatest sword fighter in the entire Caribbean,
Not
without
cocky.
A single lesson in the art of fencing?
Yep.
How did you expect to defend yourself?
Gee, I don't know.
I see. Obviously not with your razor-sharp wit. I'd advise you to seek out Captain Smirk's and get some real training.
No, I don't have time for that.
It would hardly be ethical, sporting, or even interesting to fight someone as unskilled as yourself. So
yeah.
Beat.
She's do it. I want to fight you, though. Like, I have this sword.
That doesn't seem to work.
I went all through the trouble of getting the sword.
I don't want that.
But I have it. You should...
How dare you approach the Swordmaster with...
I don't think I can do anything.
Oh, it's you again.
Sometimes you have these dialogue puzzles.
Hi, I'm selling these fine leather jackets.
Do you have one in size 3? Of course you don't. Because you're not really a jacket salesman.
Man, she's good.
Let's be honest. You're here to prove yourself... to the pirate leaders in hopes of one day being as immoral as they are.
Yep. Nailed it right on the head. Gee, you're smart.
I told
skip
you,
dialogue.
I'm not going to fight you until you get some training.
Let's see. Let's figure that out, because that's going to be annoying to sit through that for too long every time. Skip cutscene. Backspace. Aha. Oh, no. Version hot swap. Ooh. What does that do? Oh, we found a button. That is awesome. That's the old days right there. This is awesome. This is the best thing I've ever seen. Is the voice acting and sound still right though, or? No, it totally changed. Oh no, we have discovered something dangerous. I'm gonna fight you. Fight you, pirate. I have all this. Dagnabbit, I have all these skills. Oh, I've got uninteresting stuff now. Let's go back to the bridge. Alright. This is interesting.
None shall pass, but it's not what I want.
What do you want then? Have all this useless stuff.
That's pretty useless, but it's not what I want.
Really?
I want something that will divert attention from things that are really important. None shall pass.
Want something that will divert attention away from things that are really important.
None shall pass. That's pretty useless, but it's not what I want.
That will divert attention. None I already tried to pass. Give him that. The t-shirt. Stapler.
That's pretty useless, pass. But it's not what I want. Stop! You must pay a toll.
What do you want? Stand aside, troll. How much did you say the toll was? Shouldn't you have eaten me
Shouldn't
by now?
Shouldn't you have eaten me by now?
That's actually true.
I'm not hungry.
Something that will attract attention.
None shall pass.
But have no real importance, or something that will distract from something that's really important. All right. Wandering back to the island. Good old Meat Hook. Maybe he's something new will happen. Well, we'll figure it out. One way or the other, scumbuddy.
I told you, I don't have the time.
Could you show me that neato tattoo thing again?
I don't think he will. Well, he will.
Okay, but just one more time. Ha ha, watch this. Say hello, Roger.
Hello, Roger.
I can't do anything. I just realized that this is something else.
Oh, okay. Have a nice time on Melee Island.
I need something else. See, sometimes they put so much crap in your inventory that you actually don't need. There's like certain things that I kind of wish they would have added to a special edition. One of those things being teleporting from place to place. I know some people argue, that's cheating. But Full Throttle, you could just double click where you wanted to go and you would teleport there. And sometimes it would be in your advantage and other times your disadvantage because you'll walk past things or miss things that you should have seen because you're teleporting everywhere. In Curse of Monkey Island, they had it. You double click and it's like, oh, you just go into that building instead of having to walk to the building. I think this is the dock. I think this is where Stan is going to be. So can't wait to get to Stan. He was awesome.
Whatever you wantin', you scurvy lover.
Oh, there we go.
Nice night we're having, isn't it?
I sure hopes you had something more important to stop me for.
Why do you guys talk so funny?
Pirate lingo. It's how everybody talked back then. Come on, Guybrush, play along.
He knows who I am.
Sorry to bother you. I'll be on my way.
Can I sword fight you guys?
What should be wanted, you scurvy lover?
Nice night we're
having,
isn't it?
I don't think I can yet.
I sure hope you had something more important to stop me for.
Bah.
Sorry to bother you. I'll be on my way.
So, okay, well, at least I know how to stop them now. All right. Let's think. How are we going to do this? What do we do? What do we do? What do we do? What do we do? No, I don't want to go to the village. I'm going to go to the village. I don't think I can pick up that poster.
I can't pick that up.
Didn't think so. Let's go back to town. Let's go talk to the shopkeeper.
I've got my eye on you, boy. Steal anything and I break your legs. What do you want?
I could really use a breath mint. Dialogue puzzle.
Whew, you're telling me. Here, take one. Please. Take the whole roll. That'll be one piece of eight. What else do you want?
Sweet.
Do you have files?
Did you mean hanging files or nail files?
Nail files, yes. The metal kind you used to open locks
with. No, the metal kind you used to open locks with.
Ah, sorry, fresh out of those. What else do you want?
I think I'd just like to browse.
All right, so we got breath mints. Let's go talk to the prisoner
this ain't
now.
No boutique. Don't take all day.
Let's go talk to the prisoner. We got this. So we can use breath mints.
Ooh, that's refreshing.
Oh, don't use the breath mint. Give breath mints to prisoner.
Oh, Grago mint. How refreshing. Thanks. So, have you come to release me?
Who are you?
My name? Is Oris. At least I think it is. I've been in here so long I can hardly remember. You gotta get me out of here before I lose my mind completely. Can't you see? I'm innocent.
Of course. Why are you in jail if you're innocent?
But why are you in jail if you're innocent?
I was framed. I didn't touch the stupid flowers.
I think this is where I learned that those flowers are poisonous.
What flowers?
The yellow Konish Indormi flowers in the forest. It's against the law to pick them.
I may have picked them.
Would you happen to have a file?
You think I'd be in here if I did?
Eh.
All I have is this carrot cake my Aunt Tilly made me. You can have that if you bring me something to get rid of these
rats.
Oh,
I bet there's a file in the thing.
I can't stand carrot cake.
Dude, all right, let's see. Did he give me the carrot cake? I don't feel like he gave me the carrot cake.
Come to interrogate the prisoner again,
give me
again,
that carrot
huh?
cake.
So, how's the food in there?
Oh, you know, the usual. Slug, grog, gruel, rats, bugs, and body lice.
Sorry, I got hung up on the one line.
I have a carrot cake my Aunt Tilly made, even though she knows I detest carrot
cake.
Thanks,
Dress.
Keep me on top of it.
The
cook at the bar is an old friend of mine, and sometimes he sneaks me food, like pork trimmings, mostly feet and lips. But once in a while, he brings this really odd rump roast.
What was so odd about the rump roast?
Well, it's the only rump roast I ever seen with a prehensile tail.
So who'd want to frame
that
you?
Sounds gross.
I don't know who exactly. I think it was a conspiracy. And if there's one type of piracy I don't like, it's conspiracy. Look, I like visitors and everything, but I don't have much more to say. Plus, my throat's getting dry from all this talking. Why don't you go find someone else to talk to? It's not like I'm the only pirate left on the island or anything.
No, let's see. Did you want food? So I can give you food.
I don't want anything but my freedom! And maybe something to get rid of these rats.
Oh, wait. Let's do this.
Hey, this might work on the rats.
Yes!
Thanks! Here's the cake.
Woot! We got this. Now we've got a file. Look at all this progress we're making. We are killing it. We are killing it. See? And this is the way the adventure games work, man. Because his buddy's bringing him the food dressed. I think that was the key. Yeah, dude, I hit some major milestones while you were gone, scum buddy. I think we did this entire deal at Marley's house while you were out.
This door appears to be locked.
Okay, it's locked now, so we can go back up. Because I think... Wait a minute. I needed the file for something in here, didn't I?
I locked the sheriff in there.
Well, where the crap? Oh, through the hole? Maybe.
I've got the file.
Yeah, that's it. Use manual of style with shredder. I got rid of that. Give stylish confetti to heavily armed clown. Throw wax lips in fire. Sure, why not? Use file on rhinoceros toenails. Use file on lock. Pick up fabulous idol. Walk to. That's just the default. Sweet.
That was a close one. At least I got the idol.
But I'm not done with you yet.
No, Fester Shinetop.
Thought you could get out of here with the idol of many hands, did you?
Look, I can explain.
So can I. You poisoned the governor's pet poodles.
I did do that.
They're just sleeping.
Broke into her house.
The door was unlocked.
Also true.
And stole one of her most valuable pieces of art.
That's true.
No, you've got it all wrong.
Oh, really? Well, let's hear your explanation.
She said I could have it. I was just going to borrow it. It belongs in a museum. The pirate leaders told me to do it. It belongs in a museum.
It belongs in a museum.
Ta!
What's going on here?
Oh, Governor Marley.
I caught this hoodlum making off with your idol, Governor. He says it belongs in a museum.
That's right, it does.
What?
You heard me, Fester. The real question is, how did he get in here while you were on guard?
Right. This is your fault.
Go away, Fester. I can handle this.
Is that the same voice actress for Governor Marley that was in the Monkey 3 and 4? Because it doesn't sound
right.
Sorry about
him.
It's been a long time.
He's new. I'm Governor Marley. Governor Elaine Marley. So my idol belongs in a museum, eh?
Yes, it does. Gee, well.
Well.
Relax, Mr. Threepwood. I know why you're here. Believe me, you're not the first who's tried.
But I succeeded.
Although I have to admit, not many get as far as you have.
Golly.
Golly.
My lookout told me of your arrival. I've wanted to meet you ever since I heard your fascinating name. Tell me, Guybrush, why do you want to be a pirate? You don't look like one. Your face is too... sweet.
Oh, okay, cool. Aw, Wally was recast? Bummer.
I see.
Yeah, well, it didn't sound right.
You're obviously not in the mood for idle chit-chat, are you? I suppose you've got many more exciting things to do. I won't take up any more of your time, Mr. Threepwood.
Good, because I got puzzles to solve.
Boogle! Murfinkiv! Twinkly?
I really wish I knew how to talk to women.
So do we, Guybrush. So do we. So now we've got the Isle of Many Hands. Now we just need to learn how to sword fight.
Where do you think you're going, Froom Wade?
Yeah, I like CMI's Wally a lot better. I'm going to put this idol in my safe deposit box. You know, it's not too late for... I mean, I said I like it better. I haven't even got the Wally yet, but I'm assuming that I will appreciate, for just nostalgia purposes, the Wally from CMI is my Wally. Excuse me, Mr. Shinetop, but you're blocking the doorway.
Excuse me, Mr. Shinetop, but you're blocking the doorway.
I think you need to cool off.
No, don't put me in the prison.
Hand over your sword.
No, you can't have it. What? Oh,
no. This is the end of the road, my little pantalooned pal. Your troublemaking days on Melee Island are over.
You're gonna drown
me. My plans for the governor are far too important and much too near completion to risk letting a would-be pirate like you get in the way. So long,
what is
Mr.
Fester
Spicecake
up
or
to?
Droopface or whatever your name is. This might actually turn out to be a pretty good day.
That Fester. He's a bad guy. So, here's the thing. You can actually stay underwater for 10 minutes and die. Because we all know Guybrush can only hold his breath for 10 minutes.
I guess I'll be needing a sword.
What they really want me to do is try to get away from that weight for a long time, but I'm smarter than that.
Well,
pick up the weight and carry it around.
Now all I have to do is show this stupid idol to the pirate leaders and...
You're alive!
Of course!
Governor!
Hey, you can talk. Huh, who'd have known?
What are you doing here? Come to finish the job?
No, I came down here to save your life.
Oh, how thoughtful.
Fester wasn't acting on my orders when he threw you in there.
You came down here to rescue me?
It really was.
I didn't even think you liked me.
It was brilliant. I just knew how to do it.
Our first meeting was a little awkward.
You ought to know, Scumbuddy. We play enough of these, we start figuring out the little things.
But then again, so do most of my citizens.
But I'm not one of your citizens. I'm just a drifter. A nobody. A would-be pirate. Who would have known, or even cared, if you'd let me drown?
I would have, Guybrush.
Oh, Governor.
Oh, Threepwood.
Oh, Elaine.
Oh, Guybrush.
Love Muffin.
Sugar Boots.
Honey Pumpkin.
Plunder Bunny.
Kiss me.
No, we mustn't.
What?
Why not?
Not here, where everyone can see us.
Why? Are you ashamed of me?
They just met each other.
No, no. It's not that at all. It's just that many of these pirates have made advances towards me. And to avoid hurting their feelings, I've always told them that my father made me promise never to fall in love with a pirate. If they see us together, they'll know I was lying.
Okay, then. Let's go to your place.
Ooh.
Okay. But finish your trials first.
No.
I don't want you to be preoccupied.
But... I feel this sudden urge to complete the trials quickly.
That's awesome. That is awesome. All right, I got a fabulous idol. Look, the fabulous idol of many hands doesn't have any hands. So now it's all about the sword fighting. Gotta figure out how to sword fight. Gotta find...
How do you fare, gold finder?
I got your...
I'm the sneakiest footpad in these aisles.
Ah, the idol of many hands. You're a brave lad. And thank you for stealing it for us.
Yeah, no problem.
Tell me again about mastering the sword.
You must seek out and defeat the sword master. Someone in town can probably direct you.
Bah. And get yourself trained first.
I'll just be running along now.
Leave us to our grog.
Come back later and tell us how you're doing.
All right. Pixel hunting. Want some of that grog.
Hey!
Alright, yell at me,
you
whatever.
You can't come back here!
I know. Can't come back there.
Why, what's anything special about it?
Hey! Don't go into the kitchen!
Okay. Turn around.
I think it's full of that foul stuff pirates drink. That doesn't seem to work. Slashmaster, when you want a sword as sharp as your wit.
I wonder if I can.
I can't move it.
Let's push. Pull fish. There's yank. Open fish. What herbs do I have? No, talk's not gonna work. Push.
I can't move it.
Of course not. Let's see. Pull pot of stew.
It's boiling hot.
Yeah, I know.
Ooh, that's refreshing.
See, some of these won't let me actually do anything with it.
No staples to be removed.
Need this fish. I need to punch.
I think that bird will peck my hand
the
off.
The bird. Get rid of the bird. I don't know what I'm doing.
It's boiling hot.
Got stewed meat.
Ooh, that's refreshing.
Give anything to the fish. I can't talk to the bird. I can't use the sword. Is that part of it? Look at a pot of stew. Oh, look at the little Pillsbury chef. That's awesome. It's the Pillsbury Doughboy. To remind me, scumbuddy. It's been so long. I think that bird will peck my hand off. I don't know if this classic view is helping me. I was so close. Ah, I hate that I was so close. Ooh. Use fish. That's interesting. Fish is making me crazy. I don't even know what I want it for. Old music is so fun. I don't need anything else to get it. I could get it now. I just don't know how to get it because I'm a dummy. Oh, wait, I know. Hold on. Maybe I'm just timing it badly. Maybe I'm not. Bird. So I can't interact with. Oh. Yeah. Look at what we did. That's the best. You are the man. Thank you, Scumbuddy, for making that so much better. You just told me I had everything I needed, and I just needed to persist. The same thing happened to me when we were playing Full Throttle, because there's an elevator, and you just have to walk to the right part. And I was walking around it the whole time, never actually walked to it. So now I've got a fish. We got a red herring. Figure out what to do with that. It is actually time for me to probably call it a night. I really wanted to get through this. Just go see if this fish is what the stupid troll wants. I don't think it is. You know what?
Listen, I'm sort of busy right now. I'll talk to you later.
Nah. Let's see. The Swordmaster's still not gonna talk to me. Go give it to this troll. Let's just see. Do you want the fish? I'm just gonna say no.
Ah, a red herring. Pass.
I get it. Something that will distract from actually important things. That's exactly what we needed that for.
Welcome. The Legion of Dorks.
Hey, welcome to the Legion of Dorks, man. I'm guessing that was you, Scumbuddy. Dude, thanks for the follow. That's fantastic. You're the man. So, funny enough, there is a Twitch alert, and I just don't have it added here because I'm an idiot. Where are you? Browser source. Twitch alert. There we go. Can't believe I did that. My bad, you should have seen a really awesome pop-up, and you didn't because I'm an idiot. Yes! We made it to stands! And that, ladies and gentlemen, means this is an excellent place to save the game and hang this thing up for the night because it is late, I've got to get up and go to work in the morning, but I have had an amazing time. It has been wonderful. I've enjoyed it, hanging out with you guys, doing some of this Monkey Island streaming. We're going to finish this game. When we come back next week, because I've got to wait a week, because I can't stream every freaking night. That would be nuts. I mean, we can, because we kind of did Diablo last night. We're doing Monkey Island streams on Tuesdays until the game is complete. And then Thursday is Horseshoes and Hand Grenades. So if you're a fan of comedy, weird, odd news, and just general craziness with two people on a talk show, totally come back Thursday night at 8:30 for Horseshoes and Hand Grenades. We go over weird, odd, crazy news from all over the world. We have a blast doing it. We talk some games at the same time and just generally have a blast. And we usually have a pretty good turnout for that. So, Scumbuddy, if you're bored on Thursday night, please, please, please come back by when you see us go live. Aside from that, man, Monday, Tuesdays, and Thursdays are pretty much our days so far. Mondays may turn into a WoW night instead of a Diablo night with a party stream, like five of us doing dungeons. So that should be great. But until then, this is me signing off. I hope you all enjoy your week, and we'll see you right here next time for the continuation of The Secret of Monkey Island here at Two Dorks TV. Bye!